Praise the Lord. Or go to your respective countries and distribute to people. They don't have to know you. That is what the Bible is saying in verse 7. He said, every man according as he proposed in his heart. So let him give, not grudgingly, or of necessity. Necessity means, it is necessary I give to that man so that I can get that contract from him. It is necessary I give to this person so he will respect me. Of necessity. You are giving to earn. Jesus gave his life not because he wants you. He did not even know you before he did those things. Praise the Lord. But he know that you are coming. And as a child of God, he will not allow you to die. He will not allow us to die in penury. He don't want us to lose our soul.
Amen.
He has settled everything. The same grace. When you preach to somebody and say, Jesus loves you. There's somebody I was talking to, a Muslim. I had the opportunity to give him something. And I'm not giving him that thing because I want to get something. But sometimes, Jesus Christ, when he preaches, he usually feeds the people so that they can listen to the message. So, I gave him something to call his attention. And I preached to him. And he said, I have made up my mind that I will not go to church. That I told Allah that any time I go to church, I should die. That any time I go to church, I should die. I said, boy, you can't die. I said, and as I'm preaching to the person was telling me no. And at the end, he said, maybe one of these days, I will try your church. I said, just try. He said, but when I come, I will not stand up. I said, you don't have to stand up now. Just sit down. Just sit down. Nobody will disturb you. Praise the Lord. Don't give up. Praise the Lord. In that good things you're doing, don't give up. One day, you will be rewarded. Remember, prayer does not make you rich, but giving does. The more you pray, you can pray for others. You can pray. People will get sick. Praise the Lord. Let's see this in Luke 4:18. So it won't be as if I'm just saying it. Let's see this in Luke 4:18 to round it up. Luke 4:18. Yeah. The spirit of the Lord is upon me because he had anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That sent me to heal the brokenhanded, to preach deliverance to the captive. Hallelujah. Thank you. You are to preach to the poor, to repent from their ways, pay your tithe. That is what I'm preaching now. Give. I will have been praying for you. But if I'm praying for you to give, I'm wrong. And I'm not doing you any good. If I'm praying for you to give alms, I'm wrong. But I'm preaching, brethren. I've shown you from the word of God this morning. Let us amend our ways. Don't let us be stingy. Don't let us be trying to pour a new wine in an old vessel. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The little you have, let it go. And let the new one come in.
Yes.
May the Almighty God bless us this morning.
Amen.
Let us be on our feet and begin to talk to God. Let's begin to appreciate Him for what He has done in our lives this morning. Let's begin to appreciate Him for His word that has come expressly unto us. The word of truth, the word of life, even as we begin to amend our ways before Him. That Father, from today, my thoughts to my neighbor begin to become pure. I begin to sow a good seed, giving alms, paying my tithe accordingly, giving offering, bringing offering before you. I will not be stingy to you, because when you are stingy to God, you rob God. you rob yourself in return. Father, this offering I've brought to you, bless it. Begin to talk to God about your offering this morning. You might not have another opportunity before you give the offering. Begin to talk to God and say, Father, bless this offering. This offering I've brought before you, multiply it. Let it be used for your glory. Brethren, open your mouth and begin to pray. Tell God, every power that is working against my finances, let it die this morning. Every power working against my finances. Every spiritual attack on my finances. Begin to ask the Holy Ghost Fire to destroy them this morning. So far, you are not the one. Every power working against my finances. Every stealer of dreams, every stealer of vision.
Please hold your candle in your hand. Please.
Begin to ask the Almighty God to destroy them this morning.
There was a divine message for us all with our candles in our hand. It's not the blood of Jesus, but it's an instruction from God. God speaks. He did not even spend 1 hour on the pulpit. Begin to pray. Let your life be turned around and changed for the greatest and the best. Message to the preacher to read it out to us.